Hi, I'm Maddie Beer Temple here with Angela Campbell today. We'll be covering the softball game of the Plum Mustangs versus the Fox Chapel Foxes. Mustangs have a record of 11-4. The Fox Chapels have a record of 10-4, so this should be a pretty competitive game. If the Plum Mustangs win this game, they'll move on in the playoffs, hopefully to make the playoffs. It did rain earlier today, but the field seemed to have cleared up, so hopefully that won't affect too many ground balls or anything, and it should be a pretty good game today. What do you think, Angela?
I agree. Last time that they played, I believe the Fox Chapel Foxes won 8-1, so I think Plum's really going to come back today and fight back.
Yeah, after the Mustangs had a big win yesterday against Upper St. Clair of 15-0, so being that the Fox Chapel Foxes seem to have sort of an advantage against the Mustangs last time, hopefully that'll kind of even out after the momentum of yesterday's win. So the Mustangs are going to be in the field first, and up to bat first from Fox Chapel is Megan Wachowski.
Leading it off for the Foxes, shortstop number 21, Megan Wachowski.
Great way to start the game by Rachel Adamski with a strike right there. We've got two strikes, one ball. Hits it right between the third baseman and shortstop, but it is quickly brought into the shortstop, but she will still have first base. So Megan Wachowski's on first.
Batting second and playing center field, number 10, Alyssa Guzzi.
Up next at bat, Alyssa Guzzi. She hits it straight to the pitcher, and there will be an out at second base. But Alyssa is safe at first, so we've got a runner at first, one out. Up to bat now, we have Kelsey Feeney, number 22.
Chapel third baseman, number 22, Kelsey Feeney.
Count is 1-1. Hit right to the second baseman, and she will be safe at first, but it was good effort by the Mustangs.
Batting cleanup for Fox Chapel.
No, correction, she's out at first.
Tanya Holpen.
At bat now is Tanya Holben. Count is now 2-1. Now it's 2-2, so we'll have to see if Tanya will make the decision to hit it next or wait for the perfect pitch. Now it's 3-2, full count. And she hits it right center field. It is picked up and quickly got in by the Mustangs, but it is still an RBI for Tanya. Fox Chapel is now leading the Mustangs 1-0, and they have a runner on first.
The next Fox Chapel batter, Fox's catcher number 2, Sam Olbrich.
At bat now, Sam Olbrich. It's now 1-2 for Fox Chapel, 2 outs. Another foul ball. We've got the ball hit high into left field, but it is caught. And that is the first inning for your Fox Chapel versus the Mustangs.
With the Foxes in the top of the first.
So far, Foxes are leading 1-0.
One runner left on base.
And the Mustangs will be at bat.
Coming to bat. Thank you. Mustangs in the bottom of the first. First baseman, number 5, Amanda Dynoski.
Up first at bat for the Mustangs, Amanda Dynoski, with the third highest batting average on the team of .419. We'll have to see how she does here. Starting off with a strike, 0-1. And that is a strikeout for Amanda, one out for the Mustangs. Next up will be Michaela Palmieri, number 10.
Now batting Mustangs shortstop, number 10, Michaela Palmieri.
Now Michaela Palmieri has the highest on-base percentage of the Plum Mustangs, up 63%. First pitch is a foul, 0-1. And she pops it up, but it is caught by the third baseman. Great effort on her part, but unfortunately that is two outs for the Mustangs. Have to see if the Mustangs can turn this inning around. Up at bat is going to be Caitlin Malik, number 17. Caitlin has the most number of doubles for the Mustangs, tied with Michaela with 7. Count is now 1-2. With the ball right there, it'll be 2-2 now. Up to full count now, and the Mustangs have 2 outs. So as far as the first inning goes, this is up to Caitlin. And she hits it, and it is center field and is not caught, and she will take the first. Up at bat now is Rachel Adamski, number 24.
Rachel Adamski.
And she hits it just right of center field. Ooh, fumbled a little bit in the outfield, so Rachel will go to second, and she is safe. She was not tagged, and the runner on second now advances to third. Caitlin is on third base. And Rachel's got a double for the Mustangs there. Here we go, here we go. Up next is going to be Rachel's sister, Hannah Adamski.
Now batting center fielder number 8, Hannah Adamski. Pinch running for the Mustangs, number 14, Nicole Polakovic.
So far it's 2-0. Runners on second and third, so let's see if this will possibly lead to some runs in. However, it's 3-0 now. Looks like it's a possibility of a walk. And Hannah will be walked. But bases are loaded right now. So hopefully up next at bat for Mustangs, Delen Poe can take advantage of this situation. Definitely an opportunity for some runs in. And Delen hits it foul. This could be a good scoring opportunity for the Mustangs if we can at least get some type of RBI. Count is now 2-2. Do have two outs, base is still loaded. It's now 3-2, full count. This could decide the inning here. And it is a pop up. And it will be caught by the first baseman. Three outs for the Mustangs. And they will now be in the field.
In their half of the bottom of the first. No runs on two hits, no errors, and three Mustang runners left on base. After one, the Foxes one, the Mustangs zero.
Up a bat now for Fox Chapel will be number 7, Kirsten Nestle.
Leading it off for Fox Chapel, designated player number 7, Kat Nestel.
Kat Nestel. and that will be the first out for the Mustangs. Rachel started off with a strikeout.
The next batter, Fox Chapel pitcher number 23, Callie Zemankowski.
Up next is Callie Zemankowski. Callie hits it straight to the first baseman, which will be caught by Amanda Dynoski at first base.
The next batter, the Foxes second baseman, number 15, Izzy Bungo.
At bat now is Izzy Bungo for Fox Chapel. Got one out. She hits it straight to Rachel, is picked up pretty quickly. And that is a quick three outs for the Mustangs.
There were no runs, no hits, no errors, no runners left on base.
The score will stay at 1-0 Fox Chapel. And the Mustangs will now be at bat. Hopefully they can just get some momentum that they did at the end of last inning at bat with bases loaded and really just take advantage of that this time. Otherwise, it seems to be pretty evenly matched here. So up at bat, first for the Mustangs, is going to be Sydney Young, number 7. Sydney hits it just right of center field, but it will be caught for the first out, but that was a great hit by Sydney. At bat now will be Jessica Bitsura, number 13.
The next batter, Mustang left fielder, number 13, Jessica Bitsura.
One and one for Jessica. Jessica hits it to the pitcher, and it is out. Two outs for the Mustangs, no one on base, and up next at bat will be Carrie Belisario, number 1. see if the Mustangs can get some momentum here.
Now batting, Mustang catcher number one, Kerry Belisario.
And she attempts a bunt, but it goes foul. She also hits it right to the pitcher, and it will be an out. But that was a great hustle to first base, and that is three outs for the Mustangs. Still 1-0, Fox Chapel leading. Mustangs will be in the field. Mustangs appear to be in a little bit of a stalemate here, not being able to get any runs in, but still playing pretty consistent defense. So we'll have to see how this plays out as the innings go on, but still early in the game, so definitely a lot of opportunity left for the Mustangs as well as Fox Chapel, so we'll have to see how this plays out. Otherwise, it is a great day for softball. Happy Cinco de Mayo to all our viewers out there. Misconception about Cinco de Mayo is that it is actually the Mexican Independence Day from Spain, but that is not true. That would be September 16th. Cinco de Mayo is actually when the Mexicans won the Battle of Puebla. More you know. Now it's just a very popular American holiday. Not so much Mexico, but I'll definitely be celebrating tonight. What about you, Ange? Any Cinco de Mayo plans?
You know what? I definitely think I will be celebrating tonight.
All right. All right, at bat for Fox Chapel, we have Kirsten Nestle. Starts off with a strike by Rachel. Great way to start an inning. She attempts to bunt, but it will be a strike, as there was no contact between the bat and ball. Ooh, she hits it right down the third base line. Quickly thrown to first base. And let's see what the verdict is. She is out. That was a great throw by third baseman Caitlin Malik.
Mustang third baseman number 17, Caitlin Malik. It's back to the top of the Fox's order with shortstop Megan Wolkowski.
Up next, top of the order, Fox Chapel. Megan Wolkowski's up. One out, no runners on base. Ooh, she hits it straight past Rachel with a great crack. Right to center field. Quickly got in, though. And she will take the single there. One out. Runner on first. Up next to bat for Fox Chapel will be Alyssa Guzzi, number 10.
Now batting center fielder, number 10, Alyssa Guzzi.
She also attempts a bunt there, but it will be foul. Seen a lot of kind of attempts at leading, but no real attempts at stealing. We'll have to see if that'll change throughout the game. another attempt at a bunt, and that will be a strike. Another foul, the count would be 1-2. And Rachel's strikes are out, so that'll be two outs for Fox Chapel. Still got a runner on first. And at bat for Fox Chapel will be number 22, Kelsey Feeney. We hit foul, so still got a runner on first, two outs. Plum attempts to get the first baseman leading out, however unsuccessful. Count of 3-1, so we'll have to see what Kelsey does. She hits it foul down the third baseline. Full count now, so this could change the inning. And it is a strike. Three outs. The Mustangs will now be at bat.
For the Lady Foxes in the third, no runs on one hit, no errors, and one Foxes runner left on base. Our score after 2.5, Fox Chapel 1, Plum 0.
I must say, Maddie, this is a very close game.
Yeah, this has been pretty competitive, especially, you know, three innings in already, only 1-0. Both teams have been playing pretty consistently, not seen a whole lot of errors in the outfield or infield at all. It's been pretty matched evenly, I would say.
First for Plum is number 5, Amanda Dynoski.
Number 5, first baseman, Amanda Dynoski.
Now, Amanda had a great catch at first last inning to get the out. So we'll see if she can match the efforts in the cage.
And a foul ball. makes the count, 0-2. And another foul ball. Amanda's staying alive in there. With a pop-up fly to left field, and it's caught. Amanda's out. Up next for Plum is number 10, Michaela Palmieri.
Now batting Mustang shortstop number 10, Michaela Palmieri.
Another strike, making the count 2-2. And hit to the left fielder, and it is caught. Michaela is out. That is two outs.
You know, by no fault of the Mustangs either, they're hitting great. Oh. It's just Fox Chapel defense, especially in the outfield, is just relentless.
Up next for Plum is number 17, Caitlin Malik. And a nice hit right in between the third and short stop. And Caitlin is on first. That was a nice solid hit. I think that's just what Plum needed.
Now batting the cleanup hitter, Mustangs pitcher number 24, Rachel.
Up next
Adamski.
For Plum is number 24, Rachel Adamski. pop-up fly to the outfield, and it drops. Caitlin has advanced to second, and Rachel makes it to first.
Next batter is center fielder number 8, Hannah Adamski.
Number 8, Hannah Adamski, is now up for Plum. And a fly foul, and it is caught by the shortstop, and that's 3 outs for Plum. This is the end of the third inning. The score is still 1-0, Fox Chapel. The Mustangs had some great hits, you know, at their last at bat. It was just, you know, Fox Chapel just stalked them all. And Hannah, certainly not last time, but the first time she was at bat, she was walked, and we know she's definitely capable of a lot more than that. So we'll have to see if she will have any more opportunities to get some RBIs, some runs in. We'll see.
Fox Chapel first baseman and cleanup hitter number 96, Tanya Holden.
Up first for Fox Chapel is Tanya Holbrun, and she hits it foul to right field. Strike one. And it's hit right to Hannah in center field, and that's out, and that's the first out.
Now batting, the Foxes catcher number 2, Sam Olbrecht.
Now batting for Fox Chapel is number 2, Sam Olbrecht. Hit to Caitlin at third, who fumbles it a little, then throwing to first, making the runner at first safe.
Pinch running number 17, Leah Prado. Batting, the designated player number 7, Kat Nestet.
Now batting is number 7, Kat Nestet. And it's hit right to Rachel at pitcher's mound. And the runner at second is out.
next batter is the pitcher, number 23, Callie Zemankowski.
That makes two outs with the pitcher, Callie Zemankowski, up next to bat.
Taking a little break there, Fox Chapel switch runners at first. Strike three.
For the Foxes in the fourth, no runs on one.
That was a nice defensive inning by the Plum Mustangs.
After three and a half, the Foxes won and the Mustangs zero.
Definitely, I think this game is so close that it's just going to come down to who makes the fielding mistake first. You know, it happens to everyone, but these teams are just so close. I don't know what it's going to be to really make the push for the Mustangs or for the Fox Chapel to, you know, really take a lead.
Definitely. Up first for the Lady Mustangs is number seven, Dalyn Poe. Nice solid hit to right field. And she is safe at first.
Now batting right fielder number 12, Sydney Young.
Up next is number 12, Sydney Young. Bunted with a catch by the third baseman who threw it to first with an out at first.
Great place on Fox Chapel's part. They seemed to be anticipating the bunt, and so that was definitely good preparation little bit unfortunate for the Mustangs, but you know what you're going to do. Got to get it back this time.
Up next for Plum is Jessica Bitsura. Swing and a miss, making that strike two. And that will be the end of the top of the fourth.
For the Mustangs in the fourth, no runs on one hit. No,
that was definitely a good defensive inning on the Fox Chapel side.
Yeah, I think being prepared for that bunt play just made things a lot easier. The double play was just, that was great. Quick decision making on Fox Chapel's part, I think. Still time for the Mustangs, though. Game is not over till it's over, as they say.
Second baseman number 15, Izzy Bungo.
First up for Fox Chapel is Izzy Bungo. Center fielder, but she wasn't quick enough, so the runner is safe at first.
Now batting for the Foxes, number 13, Emma Humes.
Now batting for Fox Chapel is substitute Emma Holmes, number 13. In an attempted bunt, but it goes foul. Bunt with a solid throw by Carrie Belisario, catcher, to the first baseman.
It's back to the top of the Foxes order with shortstop number 21, Megan Wolkowski.
Up next at the top of the batting order is Megan Wolkowski. Thank you. with a hit down center field. And it was nice throw by Hannah Adamski to the catcher, Carrie Belisario. And the runner going home is out. That makes two outs with a runner on second.
That throw from center fielder, number 8, Hannah Adamski.
Up next for Fox Chapel is number 10, Alyssa Guzzel.
Alyssa Guzzel.
Scary foul ball there. Almost came into the bleachers, but nobody was injured. It's all good.
Baseline, and Fox Chapel scores, making the score 2-0 Fox Chapel.
Being an RBI for Samantha, and 2-0 now, Fox Chapel leading. Great hit right down the foul line, though.
Now batting for Fox Chapel, third baseman, number 22, Kelsey Feeney.
Up next for Fox Chapel is number 22, Kelsey Feeney. Kelsey has a nice home run hit right over center field,
over the fence.
That brings in two runs, making the score 4-0, Fox Chapel. That was definitely a nice hit by Kelsey.
Absolutely, we just had two great hits in a row. And you know, that might be the difference between a win and a loss for these two teams here.
Definitely.
But Mustangs have some big hitters too, and I wouldn't be surprised if they do the same thing.
There are two outs, so we just need one more out to get out of this inning, and then the Lady Mustangs will be up.
Mustangs having a little team meeting at the pitcher's mound. I'm not sure what more they can do, you know, defensively. They've been playing great in the infield. We haven't seen a whole lot of fumbles. It's just gotta get the balls in quick from the outfield, which they seem to be doing pretty well.
Number 96, Tonya Holman.
hit down third base to Caitlin Malik. She fumbles a little, but still throws the first. Unfortunately, she wasn't quick enough, and the runner at first is safe.
I think the Mustangs just need to focus on the fact that there's still, you know, two outs. There's definitely an opportunity for a quick out, and run on first doesn't necessarily always mean that, you know, that runner is going to go home. So still plenty of time this inning to keep it at 4-0.
Pitch running for Fox Chapel, number 24, Grace Katz.
Fox Chapel just switched out the runners at first. We now have Grace Katz on first.
Now batting Fox Chapel catcher, number 2, Sam Olbrich.
Batting now for Fox Chapel is number 2, Sam Olbrich. Ooh, a nice stop by the second baseman. And the out is at second. And that's the end of the top of the fifth.
For Fox Chapel in the fifth. Three big runs on four hits, one error, and one runner left on base. Our score now after 4.5. The Fox is 4, and the Mustangs 0. Leading us off in the bottom of the fifth, Mustang catcher, number 1, Carrie Belisario.
Mustangs at bat, starting off with Carrie Belisario. She is also the catcher. Starts off with a strike. She hits it foul, right of the foul line, the right foul line. One and two count for Carrie. And she hits it shallow into the outfield, but it will be gotten quickly, but a run at first is still a runner at first. I think it's important that the Mustangs just really get on base now and focus on getting these RBIs in. Up next will be number 5, Amanda Dynoski, and we're back to the start of the leadoff here, start of the batting order. And she attempts the bunt, and it goes foul.
It's back to the top of the order for the Mustangs. First baseman, number 5, Amanda Dynoski.
Now, it looks like Fox Chapel is starting to adjust to the possibility of a bunt. But she full out swings there, and it was a foul. Got another foul ball. And it is a hit left outfield, however, foul. Good attempt, though. Another foul for Amanda. Oh, this time it is deep outfield where the runners in the outfield converge and they do hit each other, it appears. Hopefully everyone's okay. Everybody seems to be shaking it off pretty well. Yeah, it seems as though the center fielder and the left fielder legs got kind of trapped up with each other and one of them tripped, but yeah, she seems to be moving around, starting to get up, so always a good sign. It's always tough when you're on the outfield and you know you see a ball, but you don't know who's going to catch it or who's going to call it. She's doing good, so that's good.
For the money. Mustangs, shortstop number 10, Michaela Palmieri.
Up now for the Mustangs, Michaela Palmieri, number 10. Kayla hits it right field, and she will be safe at first, but the runner is going to third. The ball was not caught, but she will not try to advance to home. Good running decision on Plum's part there, and nice hit by Michaela.
The next Mustang batter, third baseman number 17, Caitlin Malley.
At bat now for Mustangs, number 17, Caitlin Malik. Got nobody on first, runners on second and third. She hits it pop right up to the pitcher. So that'll be two outs for the Mustangs. Now at bat is Rachel Adamski. We've got two runners on the bases, no one at first. This could definitely bring in some runs if Rachel hits like she usually does. Catcher tries to get the runner at third out on a lead. Unsuccessful, however, did seem to hit somebody. Rachel hits it right towards the second baseman, who scoops it up quickly, and that'll be three outs for the Mustangs. Good attempt by Rachel, though. That was a very solid hit. Just a great stop by Fox Chapel's second baseman, Sam Ulbrich.
After five complete, our score remains the Foxes 4, the Mustangs 0.
At the end of the fifth inning there, the score is now 4-0. Fox Chapel leading the Mustangs. Mustangs are really going to have to bring it this next inning.
For Fox Chapel in the sixth, the designated player, number 7, Kat.
Fox Nestel. Chapel at bat. Now we have Kat Nestel. Two strikes. Thank you. one and two count for Kat. And that will be strike three. One out for Fox Chapel. At bat now we have number 23. This will be Callie Zmenakowski. Oh, and she cracks it deep center field, but it is caught by left fielder number 13, Jess Bitsura. Great catch there. Two outs for Plum. Only two hitters so far, so this is turning out to be a pretty quick inning on Plum's part. At bat now for Fox Chapel, number 15, Izzy Bungo, second baseman. One and oh, no runners on base. That's now 2-0. It is a pop fly to be caught by Mustangs first baseman Amanda Dynoski. That'll be three outs for the Mustangs.
The sixth, no runs, no hits, no errors, no runners left on base. After 5.5, our score remains. Fox Chapel 4, Plum 0.
5.5 innings, still 4-0. Fox Chapel leading. Mustangs will now be at bat. Hopefully they can change things around here these next few opportunities they get. Up first for the Mustangs, number 8, Jessica Bitsura.
Leading off for the Mustangs in the 6th, center fielder, number 8.
Correction, number 8 is Hannah Adamski. Is looking at the order, not the jersey number. Hits a foul. Now Hannah has the second most number of home runs on her team with 6, second only to her older sister Rachel with 7. Hannah is walked, She will stay at first base. Up next at bat we have Delen Poe, number 7.
Now batting second baseman, number 7, Delen Poe.
Delen hits it to the shortstop, quickly gets the out at second, but Delen is safe at first. At bat now, number 12, Sydney Young.
Now batting Mustangs right fielder, number 12, Sydney Young.
Delen just stole second safely. And she's going for third after it is fumbled at second base. She is safe. That was a great play there. Good decision making. She had plenty of time to get there. Good move by the Mustangs. So long as Sydney can get a base hit of some type, it certainly looks like a possibility that Delen could get home and get the first score for the Mustangs. Sydney hits it straight to the first baseman. It's an out at first, but still an RBI. We've got a run in for the Mustangs. First score of the game. Now it is 4-1. Mustangs only down by 3. Up next, number 13, Jessica Bitsura.
Now batting Mustangs left fielder.
No one on base.
Jessica Bitsura.
And she hits it just right of center field, but it is caught. And that will be 3 outs for the Mustangs there.
For the Mustangs in the sixth,
score is now 4-1.
No hits, no errors, and no runners left on base. Our score after 6 complete. The Foxes 4, the Mustangs 1.
Now the Mustangs still have one more at bat. It's important to keep that in mind because a lot can still change within one inning. So it's definitely a possibility for the Mustangs to get back up there right in the game and take the lead, possibly.
The 7th for the Foxes, left fielder number 20, Kirsten Nestle.
Leading off for Fox Chapel, we have Kirsten Nestle, who hits it, and it is fumbled by the second baseman, Delen Poe. She's safe at first. Runner on first, no outs. Now at bat. We have number 21, top of the order, Megan Walkowski. Leadoff hitter here, so the Mustangs should be prepared in the field. She attempts a bunt, but it is foul.
Thank you.
Another foul ball for Megan. The count is 0-2. Megan hits it deep outfield. It is not caught. Jessica Basura throws it in to the shortstop, Michaela Palmieri. And Megan has gotten a double on that, so we have runner on second and third, no one at first.
Now batting center fielder number 10, Alyssa Guzzi.
Now at bat, Alyssa Guzzi. We've got a foul ball. She hits it straight to Rachel, who makes the decision to get the out at the first. No runners advance home.
The next batter,
now at bat for Fox Chapel, Kelsey Feeney. Rachel throws it right down the middle there for a strike. And she hits it into the outfield, thrown in quickly by Jess, overthrown a little bit. Kelsey gets a double on that. And the score is 5-1. Still no one on first. So runners on second, third, not forced.
Cleanup. First baseman number 96, Tanya Holbrin.
Batting for Fox Chapel, number 96, Tanya Holbrin. Tanya hits it foul. Tanya attempts a bunt there. Thank you. tries for another bunt, but this time it goes foul. Full count now, 3-2. Once again, hit foul there. And Tanya hits it right to center field, fumbled by Hannah for just a brief moment. But it is got, does go in, and that will be an RBI and a double for Tanya. Score is now 7-1. Box Chapel leading. Angela, I think this is the third runner that just got a double in a row.
I think you're right, Maddie.
Yeah. It is popped up to be caught by second baseman Delen Poe. That'll be two outs.
That was the catcher, number two, Sam Ulbrich. Now batting, designated player, number seven, Kat Nestek.
Now at bat, number seven, Kat Nestel. She hits it right past the second baseman. Hannah quickly throws it into the pitcher. Still an RBI though. 8-1, Box Chapel. Solid hit by Fox Chapel there.
Like the Lady Mustangs are having a team meeting. I think what they really need to do now is just forget about what has happened this past inning and just work on getting that last out.
Yeah, definitely. They can't be lazy here. They got to keep up their game, despite what the score is. They still have one more at bat, so can't give up until it's over.
No, anything can happen.
At bat now for Fox Chapel is Callie Zmenikowski, number 23. She's also the pitcher.
The next batter, number 23, the pitcher, Callie Zmenikowski.
Callie hits it right past second base into outfielder Hannah. And Callie is safe at first. Runner on second, still two outs.
Come on, Iz, keep it going.
At bat now will be Izzy Bungo, number 15. And she hits it right to shortstop Michaela Palmieri. Gets the out at first. And that will be last defensive play for the Mustangs of this inning, at least.
A big inning for the Foxes with five runs, four hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Our score now, Fox Chapel 8, Plum 1.
All strikes, 2-3.
You know, Maddie, despite that last inning of Fox Chapel doubling their score, I still think the Mustangs have a pretty good chance.
I think so too, Angela. I think especially since we're starting off with, let's see, who is this? Carrie Belisario. And then after that, it's just going to be top of the order. So we're going to have some big hitters coming up. And I think, you know, just being the last at bat, they're really going to want it now. This is kind of crunch time. Let's see what Carrie can do. She bunts it. Oh, caught by the catcher. Great play. And that'll be an out for Carrie.
It's back to the top of the order for the Mustangs.
Top of the order now for the Mustangs. Leadoff hitter Amanda Dynoski, number five. Now at bat. One out. No one on base. Amanda hits it right to the second baseman for the out at first. Two outs for the Mustangs, but great hustle by Amanda.
Now batting Mustang shortstop, number 10, Michaela Palmieri.
At bat now for Plum, Michaela Palmieri, number 10, shortstop. It is hit and caught right to the first baseman. That'll be three outs for the Mustangs and the end of the game. And the game ends at 8-1, Fox Chapel winning. Ironically, this is the same score as when they last played, 8-1, Fox Chapel. But, you know, I think the Mustangs really played a tough game. It came down to, I think, a lot of little plays, little bunts that maybe we weren't so prepared for, but Fox Chapel was. But otherwise, I think it was competitive. I think it was a great game. And, you know, Mustangs just can't give it up.
Definitely was. It was very competitive. Both teams did great defensively and offensively.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I am Maddie Beer Temple.
And I'm Angela Campbell.
And thank you for joining us for a great game of the Mustangs versus Fox Chapel.